Is there a deep state? Technically, no. Depends on what you read. The New York Times is now using the phrase deep state to refer to people who work in the government from various agencies who are resisting Donald Trump. Although many people referred to the deep state in that exact way up until now. I hate the phrase, it's like a weird conspiracy, but I tell you now, things are about to light up. DOJ opens criminal probe into its own Russian collusion probe that could force former FBI head James Comey and ex-CIA chief John Brennan to testify and may even see charges brought. The reason I bring up the deep state is because it is the subject of many conspiracy theories and people are accused of all of these things, and I think there's no reason to even use the phrase, but I understand the colloquial idea behind it. In the end, let's set aside any of this, all of that stuff, okay? I get it. You talk about whatever you want, but listen. If the DOJ has just launched a criminal probe into itself over the start of the Russia collusion narrative, something's happening. And I don't know, you can call it whatever you want. Some people call it a coup. They call it, you know, internal civil war, whatever. I don't know. All I know is John Durham, who is leading the inquiry into the origins of the special counsel, has just turned this investigation criminal. Interesting. That means they're going to be able to issue subpoenas, call witnesses, force testimony, and it may result in prosecution of former government officials who may have done wrong in launching what we now know to be almost entirely a conspiracy theory based off of trash. And you know who got played like a fiddle the whole time by literally everybody is our inept and terrible media institution. The media industrial complex. They are the worst. Like, you know what? Let me say this. We have the military industrial complex, like all these different weapons manufacturers. Man, they are good at maintaining a narrative and getting us involved in these wars. But you know who's really, really bad at what they do is the media industrial complex. They keep falling for all of the hoaxes. I know, I know. Now people are going to pop out and say, Tim, the media is part of the deep state. Nah, okay, whatever. I don't care. Listen. Trump plays the media like a fiddle, but so do these government actors. Now, I don't know who did what. You're going to have the left saying, no, this is Trump striking back at those who resist him. Whatever, man. You call it whatever you want. It's happening. There is a battle going on between Trump's administration and the old guard. And it's not my opinion. Trump's war on the deep state turns against him. The New York Times, 2 days ago, the impeachment inquiry is in some ways the culmination of a battle between the president and the government institutions he distrusted and disparaged. Okay, so right now, the impeachment inquiry is being fueled by people who work in these intelligence agencies that are simultaneously being investigated for the origins of the false Russia collusion narrative. You see what's happening here? I'm not going to tell you who's right or who's wrong, but I'll tell you this. History is written by the winners. Whoever comes out on top of this one, well, they're going to be the one who writes the history. And we'll see what happens. Trump is just a dude, and he's going up against people who have extensive intelligence backgrounds and understanding. This will get interesting. But let's read this story from the Daily Mail. DOJ opens criminal probe into its own Russia collusion probe. They say, the Justice Department has reportedly launched a criminal investigation into its own probe that could force top U.S. intelligence officials to testify and may result in charges. Government sources said Thursday that the inquiry opened by Attorney General William Barr and led by U.S. Attorney John Durham concerning the origins of Special Counsel Robert Mueller's probe into Russian interference in the 2016 election had transitioned from an administrative review to a criminal investigation. It is not clear what potential crimes are being investigated, but should the designation of a formal criminal investigation prove true, it would give prosecutors the ability to issue subpoenas, potentially convene a grand jury, and compel witnesses to give testimony and bring federal criminal charges. Now I ask, the left will say, this is a Hail Mary last-ditch effort from Trump and his people to go after, you know, the intelligence agencies because of the impeachment hearing. Or you'll hear people on the right potentially say that this is them preempting Trump. The Durham investigation has been going on for a while. They knew he would uncover criminal activity, and so impeachment was intended to stop Trump before he could dig in further. You want to talk about Trump's war with the deep state? I mean, this is it, okay? It doesn't mean that there's a literal group of people twirling their mustache behind the scenes. I think what we're seeing is there is an establishment. that has an idea of what they want this country to be and what they want it to do. Trump wasn't supposed to win. I don't think it's this grand conspiracy of like an Illuminati cabal. I just think it's literally anti-Trump people. They exist everywhere. Some people who work at these intelligence agencies are probably in the resistance watching MSNBC all night. And so they're not, it's kind of like, you know, it's interesting. It's kind of like a standalone complex that because all of these people who work at these agencies are anti-Trump and come out at the same time, it looks like a concerted effort. And I think it's important to always say never for like, there needs to be some kind of like razor for how you don't assume it's a conspiracy. It's just that the simple solution, people, a lot of them don't like Trump. And the media repeatedly says orange man bad. And so these people have come together at various points and presented evidence and made claims, and it's bad for Trump. It's that simple. We'll see what happens, though, right? There's going to be accusations of conspiracy. And here's the big challenge, too. The left and the right both have their conspiratorial view of what's going on. And I'm always the person like, give me the proof. Show me the evidence. Let's not jump to conclusions. But the left is now assuming that Trump is organizing all of these things. They literally believe Trump and Giuliani are conspiring with these guys to go to Ukraine early and like smear Joe Biden and all of these things. That's a conspiracy theory, dude. Okay. You want to talk about the transcript where Trump talked to, this is what really, really annoys me about this idea of conspiracy theory. It's an obvious smear. Okay. If Trump had a phone call where he said, do X, and their accusations. It's not a conspiracy theory, okay? Jeffrey Epstein, that guy disappeared, right? Remember that guy? What happened to that? It is not a conspiracy theory to have a bunch of things happen that point in a direction and ask for an investigation. If that were the case, literally everything done by every single, like, could you imagine if every time a cop said something like, I noticed there was a guy at the dock meeting with another guy and he was passing off papers. And then and then his captain was like, that's a conspiracy theory. They were just meeting for coffee. No, you see something strange and you say we must investigate. But we're at a point now where conspiracy theory used to mean like you believe there's lizard people taking over the moon to build a giant weapon to blast Earth or something. You know, conspiracy theory used to mean like aliens are here. Now it's literally Hillary Clinton deletes her email servers and we say, hey, that was illegal. And they go, that's a conspiracy. No, she literally deleted public record. All right, listen, Donald Trump, what he's doing with Ukraine, you have yourselves a conspiracy theory. And I say that because I'm using the standard they apply today. But let's be real. If Donald Trump made the phone call, if aid was withheld, if there are witnesses, well, then we investigate it. We don't scream conspiracy. Now, if there is an investigation into these intelligence agencies, the origin of the Russian collusion probe, that is also not a conspiracy. Think about it this way. They're literally conspiracies, but how are you going to call everything a conspiracy? That's the problem. And so right now, Hillary Clinton's a conspiracy theorist. Trump's a conspiracy theorist. The media are conspiracy theorists. They say that the conservative media is all conspiracy theory. Dude, you've lost it, okay? I am so sick and tired of this phrase. I'll tell you what. History is written by the winners. We'll see who comes out on top. Maybe Trump gets taken down in the impeachment inquiry and he's out. Maybe he gets removed by the Senate. But it doesn't mean the Durham investigation is going to stop. It could be stopped, though. But if Trump is impeached, Mike Pence takes over. And is Pence going to just, you know, say, okay, that's it. Cancel the investigation. They're already there. And if they're converting an administrative review into a criminal investigation, it stands to reason they have probable cause. They have probable cause to believe a crime was committed. Now, here's the thing. We shouldn't jump the gun. Who knows what this could be? For all we know, in Durham's investigation, he found that all of these things in the Russia collusion stuff was on the level. But some dude who works in an office was selling drugs in the office. And so he was like, hey, we kind of found this. I'm being extreme in my pulling back here. It's very likely they found wrongdoing specifically tied to the Russia collusion narrative. And I think it's fair to point out with all of the dirty tricks that we've been seeing since Trump won. I mean, there was an article where it came out like an article came out almost immediately after Trump was inaugurated saying, and now the impeachment begins or something like that. Yet we know that these people don't like it. Is it a conspiracy? It's not a conspiracy, okay? Here's what you need to understand. Conspiracy would imply that like Hillary Clinton had a secret meeting with somebody and said, here's the plan and laid it all out. It's possible, okay? I just don't think it's likely. What's more likely is a lot of people don't like Trump, and they're contributing in a decentralized manner. So you end up with, you know, somebody who works in intelligence who's personally offended by Trump, and they're biased against him, and so they accept this. Then people start coming out of the woodwork, making accusations, making exaggerations, and it all starts building up to a critical mass and flows in a certain direction. There's a particular conspiracy theory I'm not going to name that CNN referred to as fake news. And this is what really bothers me, because it seems like so many people don't understand the nature of decentralized information exchange. CNN was committed to the narrative that this prominent conspiracy theory involving Hillary Clinton was fake news. And what they meant by that was that one person literally made the story up on a website and it went viral, which was not the case. CNN literally pushed a conspiracy theory about a conspiracy theory. What really happened was that different people on the internet started sharing ideas, and a distributed network of individuals created a narrative, not intentionally. That's the formation of a conspiracy theory online. CNN was trying to convince us that it was actually a cabal of fake news, pro-Trump people going, ha ha ha, and hiding in the shadows and making things up. And then you get Hillary on this podcast saying that there are flashing video. I kid you not. She said there are flashing videos that are only on the dark web and that disappear and you can't find them ever again. And it's like, what are you talking about, dude? You made that up. So look, I can rant on this kind of stuff for a little bit, but the news is very, very simple, man. We don't really know exactly what they've found. And we don't know the severity to which the criminal activity may be. And we don't know why they're converting this into a criminal case, but this could be serious. Now, there's going to be a lot of people on the Trump side, in my opinion, who are looking at this in a very, very serious manner. It may turn out everyone involved in Russia, save one person. There could be one assistant to James Comey who altered text or something. And I'll admit there are probably a lot of people who know more about this than I do, because I will tell you right now, the people who know about this are most likely going to be Trump supporters, because it was proven false. Trump did not collude with Russia. The narrative was fake. The dossier was fake. All of these smears were fake. And it was seemingly an attempt to just take down Trump. I'm not saying that people came together on purpose. It may be the case. The reason I say that, though, is while you may have read something that says the dossier, Fusion GPS, you know, steal, all that stuff, we gotta have it proven. We have to have it proven. We have to have the evidence presented. And yes, maybe you read a bunch of things that say it's very likely true. That's fine. The point is, you don't win by jumping the gun. You come out right now and start making all these claims, and they will use that to discredit you. Let Durham do his investigation. Let him present evidence and stay on top of it. But follow the line, okay? Let him draw the conclusion. Otherwise, they will try to destroy the investigation before it can finish by claiming it's a conspiracy theory. And that's what they're doing with Trump and Ukraine. Joe Biden did quid pro quo with Russia, with Ukraine. That's a fact. Now, whether or not he was right to do it or wrong is totally different. And what he was doing it for is totally different. But the fact is, Joe Biden said, fire this guy or you don't get money. That's quid pro quo. The right says it was corrupt. The left says it was to weed out corruption. Fine. Okay. It is not a conspiracy theory when you say, I believe it was for negative, you know, for malintent. That's not a conspiracy theory. Okay. That's you forming a hypothesis based on a quid pro quo and asking for investigation, the same as they're doing to Trump. You know, it's all tribal. It's all double standards. They say that Joe Biden was trying to weed out corruption. So he did a quid pro quo. Now they're saying that Trump, believing a conspiracy theory, offered a quid pro quo. Okay, wait, hold on. If it's now been admitted by Mick Mulvaney that the quid pro quo for Ukraine aid was about investigating DNC corruption, not Joe Biden, why are they upset still? Because whether or not you think Biden or Trump was correct, they're both seeking to weed out corruption, right? Yeah. Let's read a little bit here. They say the transition from an administrative to criminal is likely to elicit concerns that President Trump and his allies may be using the powers of the government to go after their opponents. Bingo. That's exactly what I was saying. The impeachment inquiry and the Durham investigation. That's it. You know what, man? I hate talking about the idea of civil war. I really do, because it seems tired and just who knows what's going to happen. But listen, this investigation, the idea of the deep state, the New York Times calling it a deep state, saying these people are coming out against them. The New York Times ran an article saying the deep state is real and it's patriotic Americans resisting Trump. At the end of the day, people are choosing sides. Either Trump is a bad guy or a good guy, and no one knows for sure because the media is lying left and right across the board. And not just lying, but everybody has a different framing of what's really going on. History will be written by the victors. So I don't know. Combine the street battles with Republicans storming into the closed hearing, with two investigations going on right now, the impeachment inquiry in secret, and you've got the criminal investigation now by Durham, and we are priming ourselves for something truly disastrous. Perhaps it results in one faction winning over, and it's a coup. Or not. Or maybe Trump, you know, wins and gets reelected. I can't tell you, man. All I can tell you is what we are looking at seems to be unprecedented, at least in my lifetime. Now, I know we had mafioso tactics back in the day, and there's some crazy stories about Nixon and what happened in the 60s. I mean, we had a president who actually got killed because some crazy dude went crazy. But so I think that's actually a good way to like kind of round this off. You look at what happened with JFK, and you've got, Oswald. It was Oswald, right? Yeah. And all it takes is one crazy person, okay? All of this going on, there. When I talk about conflict, coup, civil war, perhaps the end result isn't going to be two factions of law enforcement colliding and trying to arrest each other and people counting heads, like Matt Taibbi said, like who's on whose side. Could result in one crazy person going out and doing one crazy thing that ends everything. And that's scary. It's all scary. So I'll tell you what, man. We got two big stories right here. I'll wrap this up. The New York Times saying Trump's war on the deep state turns against him. The impeachment inquiry. But you also have Durham's investigation into the origins of Russia collusion. If it turns out that the origins of the Russia collusion narrative proves Trump's Ukraine investigation right, wouldn't that resolve the impeachment inquiry? Think about it. If this investigation shows the DNC did collude with Ukraine, as Politico stated, and did criminal activity, and then that in turn would preempt everything about Ukraine with Trump saying, I want to investigate the DNC, that he would then come out and say, see, Durham proved it. I was right to ask Ukraine for help. Currently, though, they're saying the Ukraine narrative is a conspiracy theory. All right, well, take it up with Politico, man. If Ken Vogel is that bad of a journalist, the New York Times shouldn't have hired him. So I don't know. All I know is you got two factions that will lie, cheat, and steal as far as I'm concerned. Yeah, and I say that because, not because I want to accuse anyone of doing anything. I say that because the left will claim one, the right will claim the other, and all I can do is tell you, you gotta decide for yourself, right? At the end of the day, we choose who we trust, and it's based off of our experiences in our lives, you know? If the economy is doing really, really well, and you're not someone who's easily angered, you're probably going to be like, Trump's fine, whatever. But if you're somebody who watches MSNBC and you're freaking out and you believe the Russian narrative they've peddled for years, I mean, that's it. Actually, let me show you something that's really, really crazy. And I might do a segment on this later. If you watch Fox News, you likely think the U.S. economy is great. If you watch MSNBC, you probably think it's bad. This blew my mind. It's from Reuters just the other day. You know what's crazy about this? The economy is great, and Reuters even says it. So what does that say about MSNBC and those who are charging full steam ahead into the resistance to remove Trump? I gotta say, it's freaky, man. Fox News has a bunch of really dumb stuff on it. Like, I always mentioned this a couple months ago when they had a segment on where they talked about evolution not being real, and I'm like, Fox, wow. Wow, Fox. We're still having that debate 20 years later? But I'll tell you what, man. If you watch Fox News and they tell you the economy is doing well, that's because it is. Record low unemployment. There's wage growth. We've got record job participation. The economy is doing really, really well. And I experience that on a day-to-day basis. But if you watch MSNBC, you think not so much. What is MSNBC telling you? It's a fact that the economy is doing well. Moody's Analytics shows the economy is great. Gas prices are down. Jobs. This is insane. And this is what scares me. So, you know, typically I find myself, what am I supposed to say, right? Fox News was correct about Russia. The Russia stuff was nonsense and MSNBC peddled in conspiracy for years. Fox News is right about the economy. What am I supposed to say, all right? I'm not a big fan of the big pundits. I think Tucker's pretty good. I think he's okay because he brings on opposing voices and they have these conversations. And he called me an honest liberal. I respect that. He says, I think that guy's a liberal, but an honest one, so good for him. But the right-wing opinion shows are exactly what they are. They're more bombastic. You know, I can agree with Ingram and Hannity on some things. I just think that they're bombastic, and it's hard to explain. I think I'm much more receptive to trying to understand the perspective of the other side. And I think Tucker does a decent job of that. It's kind of why I like his show. But aside from Tucker, it's like, there's a lot of stuff on there. Admittedly, Bret Baier is fantastic. But that's the thing, right? Bret Baier he's a real reporter. He's a real anchor. He brings you the facts. He's not an opinion guy. And that's maybe why you're getting truth, because MSNBC is pundit commentary across the board. Glenn Greenwald complained they wouldn't even let him on the air because he disagreed with the Russia narrative. All you got to know is if somebody watches MSNBC, their brain is being melted. So anyway, this kind of went off the rails. I'll leave it there. The news is the news. It's very simple. It's a criminal probe now. The investigation into Russia collusion has gone criminal. We'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. But expect to see. I don't know if we'll get a perp walk like some people might want to see. But I think we'll see some subpoenas. We'll see grand juries. That's the only reason they do it, which means I think they have probable cause. I think they've found something already, and that would make sense, right? Anyway, we'll see what happens. Stick around. Next segment's coming up at 1 p.m., and I will see you all then on this channel.